They're on a four-match win streak.
Yeah.
And a simple, fun storyline. One of our most hyped mid lane matchups 2 years ago when Pawn returned to the LCK.
He is right up there as a blind pick mid laner once again.
Silas first pick.
What the hell?
All right.
All right, we are hijacking this game from the word go as Karma, pretty damn good pick into the Silas, and we'll mean the Frostmancy.
Welcome back,
in.
Yorick Mori. Welcome Silas for the first time.
Do you know what the weather is on the side of King's Own Pub?
What's the weather?
It's real frosty over there.
Live and dash around things would be
this
a
would
scary
be an oldie.
One.
Is,
yeah, oldie, but potentially a goodie as Pawn locks away his Azir, and he's happy to play this champion in absolutely any meta. Whenever Pawn hits the Rift, you have to respect that the Azir will most likely be played.
It's very from Khan. It feels like there was so many debates
I know.
In what actually happened between champ select and in-game.
Oh, Faker's taking a turret shot. Yeah, that ain't generation. Great.
And no CS in the top lane, no CS in the mid lane. Welcome to week 4 of the LCK.
Yeah, a lot of zeros. And they've got double zeros on the side of SKT. As, of course, Marta's not going to be farming either. Tucson thankfully giving some extra numbers over to Kingzone.
So look, you are messing with it, that we could definitely see it at some point in week number 4.
Yeah, remember there's still 4 more days to go after this. So this is not the only
time. This is the new world we live in.
We're going to see it. And it's only a world that's going to be happening for a very short time.
I feel like as a caster, I've had the most of this because I did an Overwatch cast where we had a one-day meta. I had a Hearthstone cast where we're going to have two people cashing in quests. So we are going to have a map with so many wards.
Well, Rascal also has a huge issue with so many minions as Khan is going to get knocked up. But the kickback onto Cuz is going to even things out. And that's World Ender already on cooldown here. Cuz blowing that one very, very quickly.
Don't worry, just guys. Here's the storm. Esports is not dead.
As Rascal comes in, Khan's going to get slowed down as Cuz, doesn't find the Infernal Chain. The turnaround now. Yeah, well, exactly. If you can hijack the right abilities, and I mean, Emperor's Divide is now there on the side of Kingzone, so Faker will have opportunities. And speaking of which, Cuz's going to get a decent knock-up here as Faker has World Ender available if he wants to throw it out. Chain Lashes are all he's throwing through as he just abducts his way forward, but that's a decent snare there onto Faker. He can get his health back relatively quickly. Infernal Chains doesn't get the pullback. Faker is still sitting on that World Ender just to make sure he keeps himself alive. So interesting that he also gets the...
He's cleared.
Yeah, he's going to come on over as Pawn. We'll have to shift some sands to try and get out of the way here as the Q lands. Emperor's Divide pushes Clid out of the way as Khan flashes on forward. I don't know whether that stopwatch was one that you really wanted to do as he just gets Death Raid. I feel like if he had it, just kept walking, it would have been a better story. But unfortunately for Pawn, it is not. And First Blood goes over to Khan. Faker turns up mid. It's the 1v1 between the Karma and the Silas. And bottom side of the map, Kingzone will get first turret.
We always use that adage of when the dust settles, let's work this out. But there's so much dust, Atlas, everywhere in this game.
I know.
That we're still trying to fully understand things. We haven't even really been able to talk about Silas. This is the nightmare that they were worried about.
Think about how many wards there's going to be.
There's going to be so many.
It's going to be a most ridiculous amount of wards.
Going on this game, pretty cool. Is all I have to say about that. Speaking of pretty cool, Aatrox is going to be stunned up.
Yeah, Rascal's going to come on over here as they're just ignoring the Chaos Storm. All too easy. Abyssal Voyage delivers Deft. A kill on the bottom side of the map. Teleport will allow Deft to defend this mid lane outer turret.
21st of September? Question?
We normally do, yeah.
Nice.
I've made the joke before.
So let's try and work out where this fight is going to occur. Remember, it's level 14. Azir has, you know, just been farming. So the Azir damage here should be pretty big. He did not go into Kleptomancy to double down on gold generation. He's just an Azir with some items. Don't have the overlay right now. Khan poked out very early in the piece. It's an Infernal Drake, so no one wants to give this up
happiest
for free.
Man alive. How do you kill this Ezreal? He's going to have ultimate amounts of shield as Marta almost just straight up dies from his old lane opponent, a lane partner. He's like, I'm normally standing next to Deft. Let me do that again. No, 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 don't do that again. That's not what you want to do, Marta. He's going to have to go back home, and that is an outer turret just brute forced by Kingzone. And this is controlled play. This is strong play.
Watch Faker. He is on the prowl here. He's roaming down. It's not a TP gank.
What's the ultimate that he's going to try and pick up here as well? Is Infernal Chain not going to be gathered? And he does get the Aatrox passive with the World Ender. Keep himself alive. But meanwhile, on the bottom side of the map, Pawn's doing Pawn things. Just on his own, clearing things out. And he's just having a whale of a time.
You also do that when your former best friend just starts shooting you in the head. Because I could imagine I'd be battling with some emotions there as well as
Cuz gets the knock-up onto Faker. Doesn't get pulled back, but there's another knock-up available. Doesn't land it there onto Faker, but does use the stopwatch. Tries to keep himself alive. This Silas so far has basically done nothing this game. As Death just hanging out by himself.
Look at this screen. Look how many wards are happening when they're trying to fight in their own jungle. There's a vision advantage for Kingzone. Important update. Not enough Drakes to have Earth, Wind, and Fire on both sides because the timer is Faker.
Yeah, he's going to dive on four. There's the Emperor's Divide. Onto three like we were talking about, but it's a beautiful Devour coming in from Tucson, and no one's going to be taken out just yet. Cuz has the World Ender, so he's not under any threat. And Deft, it was like he wasn't getting hit by anything.
Did 65% of Teddy's health bar with the ult. Ult available by Teddy, but smartly doesn't fully engage. Was worried about potential turn from the Karma in a team fight, but the poke remains supreme when the hard engage is down. They can just chase onto Faker.
Yeah, they're trying to punish him. In comes Pawn, as now Faker tries to keep himself alive with the W, but it's not going to be enough, and Rascal's going to be able to grab that one. Faker dead. Kingzone might look at Baron.
Hard engage versus poke. If the hard engage doesn't get kills, the poke reigns supreme with the ults on cooldown. They're chasing for more.
Yeah, looking for it. None of the Qs land here from Death, though, so they can't get any of the procs on the Iceborne Gauntlet.
The enemy tries to annoyingly take it down. They have wards everywhere.
Kingzone don't have enough vision, Papa. That's exactly why they needed to put that one down.
You can be so much more risky with how low you get the Baron down because of the vision, but they need to account for cleared. Here he is.
Yeah, he's going to turn up. Not going to get there in time, though, as there's the special delivery. Clid goes down. Deft has the auto attack. And that's the Baron. That's a kill. And that's everything going to Kingzone.
And that's the problem, is you're basically Uber Eats here if you're side of Kingzone. They know what move's coming, you know. That's the reality here. They've got the whole cam, if you know poker, so... Because of that, let's see if SKT can make something happen.
Yeah, they're trying to blow up Deft, but he's already well and truly back in this one. Faker goes into his golden form as Cuz going to get devoured. Tucson going to keep him alive as Cuz diving on forward. World Ender is going to put him back up again. Has the GA as backup after that one, as well as Clid tries to get in, but Deft down to about half health. Has the shields back up again as Marta's taken down by Pawn. The Empress Divides are traded backwards and forwards, but it's Kingzone that's able to come out on top. The double comes in for Pawn. That's the ace, and that'll be the game. Triple kill for Pawn. His Azir is super good, but this game has been super weird.
SKT at least are able to force the fight, but at this point it's against double Infernal Drake. The damage has been done from the early game, and Kingzone getting all the wards, playing quintessential Frostmancy, will take down game number one as they look to upset SK Telecom T1 on the first day of patch 9.3, no hotfix enabled.
Yep, and I feel like there's also a draft phase for Frostmancy as well. Khan was the one that managed to get the real one, where you start the game with your Frostfang and you've got the Kleptomancy as well, and then we've got Airy, and we start with a Corrupting Pot and then build it.
As we see, 30,100 damage. Let's put the numbers here, 17, 22, 31, about 36,000 damage altogether. Done by SKT, so Kingzone able to roll through there. He does the same as the rest of his team, about 50% damage share. I remember Def doing 50% damage share a lot at 2014 Worlds, and they almost made it to the final.
2015 as well, he didn't
did
stop.
Samsung Blue, and like you say, had some great Deft hands. It's awkward to say when his name's Deft, but on EDG as well. Yeah. So welcome back, Deft.